Every man wants to be successful and craves financial security. However, in the grand scheme of things, nothing is more important than good health. In today's video, we will be sharing with you the story of a woman who has a very rare disease that made it look like her brain was growing on the outside. Curious to find out how this is even possible? Stay tuned to find out. Marcia Lobato is a 35-year-old woman who lives in Santarém, Brazil. She was born with a very rare disease that is known as cutis vertitis gyrata, also known as CVG. CVG is a congenital or acquired disorder that causes the scalp to present folds and hair loss in the affected part. It occurs more commonly in males and mostly develops after puberty, but before age 30. Patients are either born with CVG or it is acquired after some illness or skin mole. Marcia's case is the former. The disease is a dermatosis that resembles the shape of a brain. Hence, when Marcia's mom looked closer, she believed that her daughter's brain looked to be growing on the outside. The disease has compromised half of her skull and caused her scalp to present folds. It has also caused hair loss in the affected part. Marcia is receiving treatment at the Lower Amazon Regional Hospital. However, for a long time, she never recognized that she had the disease. She said, "I always considered it a sign. When I went to Belém, they discovered a giant nerve and now a giant angioma." Marcia has also been the subject of curious looks wherever she went. However, she has learned to live with the condition and is not sorry for who she is. "I've never been ashamed. People look different, but I've never had problems like that. Just a headache," she said. Her scalp has also shrunk to more than half of its original size. However, despite more than 50% of her scalp already being affected, there is a cure for her disease. Doctors state that because her scalp has already been affected, her surgery will have to be done in parts. And when asked about her recovery, her doctor said, "We predict that she will recover because it is not a complex surgery. It will require a little patience because expanders can be placed to expand her healthy scalp so that we can recover the part that is altered. I wish Marcia a full recovery, and I hope her scalp returns to normal in no time." Sometimes early detection can be just what saves a patient from an ordinary disease becoming a deadly one, and this was certainly the case for this woman in Ohio. The pandemic stopped a lot of things. One of them was going to the salon. While this might not seem like a major inconvenience, not being able to go to the salon almost changed Caitlin's life forever. Because instead of the hairdresser, it was her husband who made the startling discovery on her scalp. Caitlin's husband is 6 feet tall, while she is 5 feet 5 inches. While gazing down at the top of her head, he told her that mole on the top of her head is changing and looked worrying. Caitlin said, "It went from the size of the end of the pencil to the size of a dime in probably a month and a half. Maybe a hairdresser might have known, but I wasn't getting haircuts. So if he hadn't noticed, I think things would have turned out very differently quickly." She saw a dermatologist, and her biopsy results revealed that she had a melanoma that required surgery. Doctors also needed to perform a biopsy of her lymph nodes to make sure the deadliest form of skin cancer hadn't spread. Luckily, it hadn't. Had her husband not discovered the mole, it could have spread to her brain. During the surgery, doctors removed a tennis ball-sized area from her scalp and used skin from her groin to close the wound. Caitlin also had to wear a pressure dressing sewn to her head for a week to promote blood circulation and for the skin graft to take. She's also had another surgery to reduce the graft and scar. Caitlin was very lucky to avoid skin cancer. She said, "It was a little bit of a shock at first, but perspective is everything. I'll take a bald spot over chemotherapy or worse." Sometimes life throws at us curveballs that present obstacles that might seem impossible to overcome. This next story is one of strength, courage, and not letting your challenges define you. When Brooke was just 7 years old, she was diagnosed with the rare genetic condition Pfeiffer syndrome, which affected her head, facial features, and bone growth. Brooke's eyes would even pop out, and her elbow wouldn't bend. She also had trouble smelling and breathing. Her family took her to Chicago to have major surgery, but it also came with a painful recovery process. But this is just one in a series of tests, scans, and other medical procedures she had to undergo. Brooke said, "I've had surgery all my life. It took her a month to recover from the operation, and she had to wear a halo device post-surgery that helped to move her face forward and her eyes back. However, the surgical process and the pain that came with it was well worth it. Brooke was able to return to school and became an honor student at Jefferson High School. Brooke hasn't allowed a condition to define who she is. Although from time to time, she has to miss school because of her surgeries, she is still taking honors and AP courses and graduating with a 3.4 GPA. She got into Western Kentucky University, and she decided to be in the medical field because she sees it as a way of giving back to all the doctors and medical staff that have helped her. Brooke has thrived despite her facial difference and bone conductive hearing loss. She has built a successful career in her profession. She runs her own podcast, and the best part, wait for it, she also found love. Brooke is engaged and will be getting married very soon. Isn't that awesome? Brooke made lemonade from the lemons life offered to her, and she also learned from her condition. She said, "It taught me that you can overcome anything. I know it sounds rough. You need to have a positive attitude. If you have a negative attitude about life, then you are not going to live at all to the fullest." From Brooke's story of guts and courage, even under the gravest circumstances, here's another story of a teenager who defied all odds to survive. From the moment Mariana was born, her mom could tell something was wrong. Mariana could not hold her head up, and neither could she sit or crawl, as her head was too heavy. At every visit they had with their pediatrician, Mariana's parents spoke about their concerns about their daughter's health. So when Mariana was 6 months old, the pediatrician referred them to a neurologist. Mariana was diagnosed with hydrocephalus, a condition in which fluid accumulates in the brain. 2 days later, Mariana had surgery to put a shunt in and stop the fluid from accumulating in her brain. With the shunt in place, Mariana started making progress. However, 2 years later, her parents got terrible news that they never expected. Mariana was diagnosed with Pfeiffer syndrome. Pfeiffer syndrome is a rare genetic disorder that causes bones to fuse prematurely or extra bones to grow in different parts of the body, including the skull. For the first 5 years of her life, Mariana spent a lot of time in the hospital, where she met over 16 specialists, and she was also rushed to the emergency department several times. Mariana's skull became fused together, and she also had a lot of respiratory issues. While people diagnosed with her syndrome have 30 to 50 surgeries over the lifetime, so far, Mariana has only had 3 brain surgeries. Mariana is also due for a big facial reconstructive procedure to move her whole face forward over 3 months. But her mom says that rather than be worried about the procedure, Mariana is excited about having the surgeries, as she knows it's for her benefit. Mariana has grown into a confident teenager and deals with her condition so positively. She says, "I have big eyes because I have Pfeiffer syndrome," or strikes her signature pose and decides to take the stairs as a compliment. Life is not always perfect. Like a road, it has many bends, ups and downs, but that's its beauty. And while some health challenges can indeed be overwhelming, this next woman's story shows that it doesn't stop you from still enjoying life to its fullest. Gabriella Lowe is a 30-year-old woman who lives in New Zealand. When Gabriella was just 6 months old, signs of her condition became apparent to her family. Gabriella's mom, Jan, said she used to scream for hours and hours because she knew she was losing all the things she used to be able to do. Before, she could use her hands, and then all of a sudden, she couldn't hold a bottle and couldn't pick anything up. However, when Jan took her to various doctors, she was told she was being paranoid and overreacting. But Jan's motherly instincts told her something was wrong. Gabriella wasn't diagnosed until she was 6 years old. She was diagnosed with Rett syndrome. Rett syndrome is a rare genetic, neurological, and developmental disorder that affects the way the brain develops and also makes the patient's head smaller. Gabriella could not walk or communicate. One specialist told Jan that her daughter's condition is a death sentence, as most people who have the syndrome don't live past 18. Well, Gabriella proved them all wrong. Gabriella learned to walk and only requires a little assistance to move from place to place. Although she can't understand what people are saying, Gabriella has learned to pick up on tones and emotions. She can also watch programs, play games, listen to music through a tablet that tracks eye movement, and if you turn down the volume of Gabriella's music, she would surely let you know and turn it up herself. Amazing, isn't it? Not only has Gabriella survived, she's also got to enjoy the simple things of life. These women's stories prove that only the harshest personal experiences open our eyes to the immaculate possibilities and the splendor of our world. Do you have any similar stories of women who had rare diseases? Share with us in the comments.